Hi there, so it's the Pest Interceptors again, trying to save some honeybees. This one, we're not really certain, like everything with bees, we're not really 100% certain what we're going to uncover here, because, Vic, I don't know if you want to show this without falling over the side of it, but what we've got is what we call weep holes in the UK, which are these like breathing air slots all the way along here. And the bees, they're coming, they're from this one, look. So we'll give these a little bit of smoke, see if we can calm them down a bit, because they're a bit... It's a bit annoyed with us, to be honest with you.
I think that might have gone out.
Okay. I've already given her a bit anyway before we started filming. But the thing is, on this one, look, so if we think... Well, we've got an option, really. The truth of the matter is, it's either four or five colonies or one really, really long colony. But we don't really know. Usually on jobs like this, we would usually come from underneath, so in the bedroom that this would be. But the guy has just had an extra ceiling put in, so we'd have two ceilings to get through, and he literally put it in about a year ago, so he's not really keen on us going in that way. So this time we're going from the top. We'd usually come the opposite way up. But as we can see here, this is the main entrance point. Just down there, we've already pulled this bit away. If we look in here, you can see them all down there. So what we're going to find, God only knows, really.
It could either be one colony there, and they're using those holes.
You know what worries me? There's two weep holes, or seep holes, or whatever you call them, here, that aren't being used by this colony. So if it had started there and come this direction...
But I think the joists are running this way, which is going to be a nightmare.
That's what I'm saying, if the joists are running that way, then it's multiple colonies.
Well, let's just hope that there's a gap right where the wood butts up to the wall, and there's a gap behind each timber, and that's where they're going through.
Yeah. Look at these, and smack down by their main.
So I guess we're going to have to take up this felt next and see what the crack is underneath this.
Yeah, shall we, let's crack on and see what we can find. Okay, so now, as you can see, we've spent the last hour or so cutting this back. Let's see what's underneath the felt now.
In the hand of it.
Alright, so here we go. Oh, Christ.
Wow.
That's the camera behind you as well.
So it looks like they're all the way down this gap.
The first thing we've done, as you've seen on that time lapse bit, is we've taken all this felt away from this wall here. Obviously, we're quite high up, you might not realise that if he was. So, and what we've done, we've now peeled all this felt back to see what's underneath, and what we can see so far, other than there was an old wasp nest here, that's an old wasp nest we can see, but in here we can see there's lots and lots of bees in this section, and that's another part of a wasp nest. It's a bit of a conundrum, really, this one, because there's five entrance points there, there's one entrance point there, so that's six entrance points. We've got a massive clump of bees here. Then there's nothing that we can see anyway. Can't see anything. And then we get to this bit. So I think there's two colonies.
Yeah, this might be a smaller colony.
I think what's happened is that was maybe the original colony. We've said this before and it ended up getting stung to pieces by the Africanized bees, didn't it? So let's hope not. But I think that looks like a smaller colony. But I think there's definitely two colonies in one again here. So we'll have to go and get another nuke at some point and start taking them apart. Let's see what we find then, Rick. If you want to start taking it apart, I'll take the camera off you.
Yeah.
Okay, so what teeth on it now, because there we go, a pack of blades in. Do we bring them more?
No, they're still in the back of the truck, mate.
They've got a bit of something they're trying to get me, doesn't it? It's an earwig.
Where are they, do you know?
Yeah, they're in the top shelf at the back. Yeah, I hate earwigs as well. Go on, girls. Get a bit of a nasty earwig. Don't sting each other. Well, don't be silly. Take off.
It's hilarious. I think that one's basically committed suicide just to kill the earwig. It was already dead.
Oh no, there it goes. Look, it's off of it.
Took the earwig.
Wow.
Made it.
Just shows you how strong they are. There's a drone. I just sort of.
A bit annoying. I lost mine, isn't it? I hope I ain't fully lost it.
As you can see, doing this in this, it's not even that hot today. It's a lot cooler than it should be in the UK this time of the year, but everything's hot work when you're in one of these suits. These are supposed to be breathable suits, but not that breathable. So this is where we find out what's actually underneath there. And can I just say, while we're here, you really should subscribe to our channel, all right? It really helps us, it really supports us. At the end of the day, we're out here getting stung, saving bees. You wanna be subscribing to us, guys, really. Let's see what we find.
I just pulled up a big piece of comb, mate.
So, which one are we going to take out first is the next decision, this one or that one? Yes. Yeah, they'll be fine, aren't they? This will get robbed out then by other bees, and these bees over here. Then we'll start that one tomorrow. What we've got now is, we've got the first colony open. We were correct, there's more than one colony. This is the first colony we're going to take out. As you can see, this is the board that was underneath the felt of the flat roof. We flip that over, you can see this here. Obviously that's upside down. You can see all these bees here, they're all drinking away at the honey. What we're going to do, we're going to take the bits of brood that we want. When we say brood, it's the bits that's got the eggs in and stuff like that, and the little grubs, and we're going to put that into these frames, and then these frames are going to go into that little mini hive, which is called a nuke. And then we'll leave the bees to clean up all the honey. Well, the honey that we don't put inside that bucket there, because that's going to go in a jar and we're going to sell it to you later on. So you can see them actually coming in and out of there, that where the weep hole is, the other side there, look. They're coming in and out of there thinking, oh, what's going on? So Let's commence then, sir.
No, it's on.
Okay, so we're going to clean queen clip each. Catching the queen. Just sit this bit here for a minute. And then what we're going to do, as the sheets come out, I'm going to put an elastic band around them, or a rubber band, I should say. Oh, these are lots better than the other bands look. You can see I'm getting quite a bit of... you're sat right in front of the other camera now.
Oh yeah.
Flaps, you should put it on here. Right, let's get the first piece out then.
We don't know what to do about that yet.
Well, they seem to be quite happy on there, don't they? Oh, I've got one trying to get into the old wrist again. Look, why do they love my wrist so much, Rick? Leave me alone.
Oh. First thing, first one. That is crazy. I don't know if the camera will be able to pick that up, but it's actually moving.
Oh, you can actually see the bladder. See, that's the thing, when you get stung by a bee, little lady bee.
It's still moving.
She'll leave the sting inside you, and that's the ones that really hurt. Because there's a little tiny bladder on the end of them, and that little bladder keeps pumping out the neurotoxins. That's always nice. Could you pass me the duct tape again, mate? Honestly, will someone make a decent design bloody suit?
That comb is in such organic shape.
This is going
to be a nightmare to get it in there.
You're going to have a problem with that, aren't you? I've not got a massive amount of faith in the
suit.
Wasp,
yeah. No, it's kind of worrying me, but I'm trying to think about it.
One dead wasp. Right.
It's not like we've not been stung before.
No.
Right. Are you ready for a piece?
I was born ready, mate. Born ready.
See, it looks like an awful lot of drone stuff. Oh, wow, look at that. It's loose.
Oh, because we've broken it off from the top, maybe?
Yeah, you'd have thought they'd have stuck it to the bottom.
How strange. It's almost like they've only just stuck it to the top, isn't it? There's a drone again. Is that rubbish?
We're kind of.
First piece. So. Rather annoying, I forgot to put my glasses on.
What on earth is that?
That's a beetle of some description, mate.
Is it a bee or a beetle? I think it's a bee. I'm going to show the camera. That looks insane.
A big spider or something?
Look at that. Is it a hornet that's been that's incredible.
Is it a hornet that
It looks like a hornet that's been propolite. I'm keeping that. That's amazing.
Look at that. That's incredible.
I'm keeping that.
Because what they do, they vibrate around the hornet, don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
They form a ball and they vibrate around the hornet. And
then one.
Because if the hornet gets back to its nest and says, "Oh, I found some honeybees," it'll bring all its
cronies,
all its cronies, yeah, all its mates, and they'll come back and attack.
This is not really anything.
Well, where there's honey, there's money, son. Let's have it.
Get everything off this.
About time you found a queen anyway, isn't it? That's all that.
Yeah, it is. I'm due.
Yeah, they've built this really strangely, haven't they?
Yeah.
It's like that piece there, it's all like joined together. So there's another one. So there must have been a hornet's nest around here at some point. As you can see, that has been cooked alive. Really spooky, isn't it? They've taken all its legs off as well. Same as the other one. Apart from its back legs. Madness. What they do is they form a ball around the hornet and start vibrating, and the bees can stand something like half a degree hotter than the hornets can stand.
I'm trying to attack it, look.
Look how much they hate them.
Look.
They know what a hornet is, don't they?
Yeah.
That's mad. Let's see how many more we can find in there then.
Look at that, he's landed on it. See if he does it again.
Where are we going to put them? By your glasses?
Yeah.
This looks like what's happened to my colony at my house. You know, I said like the comb fell over inside
yeah.
it. That looks like what's happened here because that one's literally on the floor. No brood at all. We might be looking at a queenless hive.
That's just empty comb, that. Another one again.
The whole demeanour has changed. God. I think the battery's dead. It's all fell down inside.
Oh man. Life gets very complicated with these, doesn't it?
They've all moved apart now. There's a queen on there.
No one can spot a queen, I'll buy you a drink. Into the nuke then. So basically what usually happens is the comb is in sheets and then the sheets we can put inside these frames. Okay, and then we can put the frames inside the little nuke over there, the temporary hive. But this roof has got so hot that the wax has melted and it's all falling on the floor. And we've got a feeling that this might be a queenless colony.
Yeah, you can see it now.
Okay, so now we've reached this part of the colony. You can actually see where all the comb has collapsed because of the heat banging down on this roof all day in the summer. This has collapsed. When it's collapsed, it could have killed the queen. So now we've got the added problem of moving a queenless colony.
Or we could join them to them.
That might well happen, isn't it? Because, let me just see if we can get down here a bit. Oh. Yeah, that's the end of it there. And all I can see is honeycomb, mate.
Yeah, there's no brood anywhere, is there?
So, it's a bit of a learning curve again, isn't it, this one? Well, we might as well get all this out. Put it all back together, let them rob it. There's definitely two colonies here because I keep on seeing bees trying to sting each other. I say let's get this all out, put as many of these bees as we can in there.
Maybe give them a sheet of honeycomb, two sheets of honeycomb for themselves.
And leave them all to sort themselves out really. look where my camera is, just above the bucket of water.
That would have been funny.
Because if that falls forwards, look. So what are we going to do? Let's take this out. Put as many of these bees in the nuke as we can, as we go.
Yeah.
Take all the honey out. Right, get rid of all of that and then put the hive there. Seal it back over and let the bees do what they're going to do.
Yeah.
And who knows, we might come back and have a load of bees in the... What we want is one piece of comb, really, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah,
that we can put in this frame, then we can put it in the nuke.
Oh,
What about that bit you chucked on the floor, to be honest?
That didn't have no...
But that's got bees from every colony going now.
This is an absolute nightmare when it's like this. Oh, there's another hornet.
So there must have been a hornet's nest around here somewhere and...
there's plenty of flipping wasps for that.
We're just going to have to make a sheet up somehow, aren't we?
Yeah.
I honestly think what we've got to do, mate, is just take all that honey out of there.
Do this one and come back to do that.
Leave it for maybe a couple of days.
And come back when we've got frames for that once we've run out of
frames. And when it's, when that's all been cleaned out.
Yeah.
And we'll leave the that.
We'll get that out today.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
It's just a shame it's none of it straight. And I've got
what about that piece that goes down that way there?
There. Or this?
This against this.
There,
I was looking at that bit. I'm going to try and edge my way towards it. So that's drone brood luck. But for some reason they've started putting honey in, and that's... You can see the difference in the size. Gotcha.
That got me good.
How's that feel, Rick?
God. Number one. God. That hurt.
You gotta see your glove.
The thing is, I didn't even see it sting me. Oh man, I forgot how painful it was.
Well, I think all we can do now is just take all that out of there. Put the temporary hive, the nuke, in there and see what happens over the next couple of days, isn't it? Two colonies, one roof.
Again?
Again? I mean, what's the chances of that, man? That's two in a row, isn't it?
Well, then again, that was on two separate parts of the house. Bees everywhere. They're all over my shoes. This would not be happening if that comb was all flat.
Yeah.
Because now there's honey everywhere from it being squashed. Now there's bees all over the honey. There you go. Hey, look at that. You got it out?
Yeah.
Hold it closer.
So you can see our problem is you can't get this out. This is the problem, isn't it?
Yeah, you can't put that in frames.
I wish you could feel like a bear ticket this out, yeah. I'm sorry, it's going to... Did you get me? Right, I need to...
The problem is, are we going to cover it up and have the nuke in there? That's the only issue.
The wasps are here. What do we know then? We've got two colonies. This colony, basically, I'm sure you've seen earlier on the video that we were describing, as long as the video didn't turn off because the battery went. Basically, we think what's happened here, there was a queen in this colony, and a few... Was it last month?
No, it was only two weeks ago.
About 2 weeks ago, we had like super records temperatures around here, and I think this roof got that hot that the comb all melted and it fell on its side, and then what's happened is it's killed the queen, basically. So we've got a queenless hive. So this one would have died out basically pretty soon, I think. Because they couldn't work in that hive anyway, because everything was on its side, wasn't it? Everything was knackered. So really we're kind of at a quandary what to do now. I think what we're gonna have to do is leave the bees to clean all this up. We'll take all this comb away and this comb away. We'll leave this nuke here. You never know, perhaps we'll come back and there'll be a load of bees in it. I doubt it. And then we'll come back either tomorrow or I think we need to leave it 2 days, to be honest, just to let nature clean all this out for us. Then we can seal this up to stop any other bee swarms turning up and taking its place. But the best thing for cleaning honey up is thousands of bees. And as you can see in here, Rick, on that bit that's spilt out in the bottom, might as well let them get on with that. And that's it, like, I'd like to say it's job done, but it's not, is it? Back to our nightmare in the flat roof, I think this one might be called, Rick. As we were saying before, what happened is this roof has got hotter than it's probably ever got since the building was built. When we had a super hot couple of days, 2 or 3 weeks ago. And we think what's happened is that all the wax has got that hot, it's collapsed. So there's no queen, and it's killed the queen basically. That's what we think has happened.
Yeah, because there's no brood, is there?
So what we're going to do, we're going to leave these girls now, and because there's robber bees here, bees from the original colony, and as you can see, there's honey absolutely everywhere. So we're going to leave them to clean up all the honey. You can see them all sucking away like mad down here. Look, you can see them pumping it into their bodies. And then what we're going to do later on, we're going to come and we're going to fill these voids up with some insulation so that they can't get back in there. Flop this back over, put the wood back in, and then we're going to leave it for a few days before we come back and get this one. And we just really, really hope that the same thing hasn't happened to this one, because otherwise it's going to be two dead colonies, really. Because there's no way that one could have done anything for itself. The workers, could they have made a new queen in there? I don't think so.
Well, there's no queen cells and there's no signs of any brood whatsoever.
No brood whatsoever. It's a very strange thing. Perhaps...
That one's trying to sting you, I think.
I mean, there is a chance. I suppose what could have happened is, well, I don't know. I'm guessing, really. That's the truth of the matter. We are kind of guessing. I guess we'll have a lot of answers when we get this one open. I mean, could it be a situation where they've come here, the swarm's come there, built a load of comb, and then it's got too hot and collapsed? And because there's no queen there, because it's killed the queen, they're just thinking, oh, well, let's build a load of, let's just store honey, store honey, store honey. I don't know. But there was brood chamber, there was...
drone brood.
Drone brood, wasn't it?
A lot of it, I'd say 20% of it was drone brood.
Another mystery. But as always, if anyone can give us any decent advice, then we're all ears. Well, we're just going to let them get on with it. Luckily, for once, in August, it's not going to rain in England.
Until tomorrow,
they're going to tip down. So hopefully when we come back later on tonight, this will all be cleared up and everything will be calmed down. Rather annoyingly, I don't think the sun goes down till about 10 o'clock tonight. So it's going to be a long day, Ricky. Okay, so we're back on the flat roof removal, which has turned into 2 bee colonies rather than just one. We haven't gone back up there just yet. We've been left them now for about 4 or 5 hours. Basically we want them to do a lot of cleaning work for us. They need to get rid of all the honey, because that can attract other pests and other swarms and things like that in the future. So the more we can get the bees to do what we want them to do is good, but as you're probably working out from these videos, they don't usually play by the book. So we'll see what we find when we get up there, and wish us some luck. I think what we're going to do, we looked at the weather report, and for the next 2 days it's torrential rain. Looks like the rain might be here in 20 minutes as well, which is a bit of a nightmare. So really we ought to get on and get up and batten down the hatches, because it's August in England and it's brilliant, you know. See you later. Next thing on this job is we want to make sure these void spaces, that the bees can't get back into them. we're going to hope that this queenless one, we're hoping in a couple of days they'll all be inside that nice little nuke. If not, well, we'll deal with that when we get to it. But these sections, we're going to fill up with insulation now so that no other bees can get in through those weep holes and get into these parts for the future. So let's get on with that then. Go on, Rick.
Finally, at the end of day two, I think. Well, apart from packing all the tools
day
away.
One.
Day one. Is it only day one? It feels like day two. As you can see, what we've done, we've made everything watertight. We've had to do a bit of a rush job. Because if you look over there, that's a local nature reserve. Look at Kent Hills over there, look. We got rain coming, man. We got rain coming.
Oh, that's, I can hear the thunder. Oh, no, it sounds like a bike.
A motorbike. So that was a bit of a race, but it's all done. What we're hoping to find when we come back in a day or two, depending on the weather again, thank you England for your beautiful weather. Hopefully these bees now, the only place that they can go is through the one weep hole which is there, which is a horrible wasp next to. Blackbird down there, I thought it was a rat then from up here. So, basically the bees can get in through that weep hole. The only place that they can get to is a little tiny hole that we've cut, like a little flap in the felt there, into this nuke or this temporary hive. So fingers crossed, we'll come back in a couple of days, this will all be full. We've put as much comb in there as we can. There was no brood comb in there whatsoever, so God only knows what's been going on really. And who knows what fun we will find under that one.
Yeah.
Because I think that's going to be a bigger copper.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's going to be way, that one there is going to be way bigger than that.
And yet again, 10 years we've been doing this and I've never seen this happen before, so. Right, let's get all the stuff down then. It was quite a good haul of honey though, Rick.
Oh yeah, all they did was make honey.
That's all they've done.
They haven't even bothered trying to rear a new queen.
But a lot of this can stay up here until we come back, I feel.
Yeah.
Okay. See you soon.